At the end of the day, baby might die.
Wow. So, but as they say, prevention is better than cure.
Yeah. There are lots of couples that come together and they're like, oh, wow, we'll get my but we will not have.
Oh, wow, wow. Welcome back to the CSA series channel. I'm sure you've been enjoying the entertainment we've been giving you all. But today, we're about to talk about something that is not well known among a lot of people in Nigeria and also in Africa. And it is something that has been causing a lot of issues. So today I have here with me a professional in health and safety and also a microbiologist. Her name is Sandra. Sandra, can you say hi to
us? Hi.
So, but I discovered that it is possible for two people to be AA and yet not compatible. And that is what Sandra will be explaining to us today. So, Sandra, can you tell us, because I need to understand why I will meet a girl that is AA and I'm AA and yet I cannot marry her. Please, can you just explain?
Nobody said you cannot marry her. What we are talking about is rhesus incompatibility.
Rhesus
incompatibility.
Okay, rhesus incompatibility. Wait, you mentioned a very deep word. You know, there is an issue I have with most medical people. They feel everybody they speak to are medically inclined already. That's why you will go and buy a drug in a pharmacy. The pharmacist will prescribe the drug for you. You will write one thing that is only another doctor that can read it. Your own drug, or drug everything that you want to drink of. So you said rhesus. If you call rhesus for me, and there is a film already.
Oh, wow.
That film, it will make a very nice movie name now, rhesus. So please, can you tell us, what is rhesus like?
Okay, rhesus factor is a certain kind of protein found on the surface of red blood cells.
A certain kind of protein,
yes,
found...
Yes, a protein found on the surface
on the
of,
surface of
blood
red
cells.
Blood cells.
Yes.
Okay.
So as of 2019, a total of 41 human blood grouping systems is being recognized by the International Society of Blood Transfusion, ISBT. Now, the two important ones they always recognize is the ABO and RH human blood grouping system. When we talk...
You see that you talk now, ABO. ABO, what is ABO?
ABO, the normal blood group we all know, A, B, and O.
Okay. So the O, the B,
the A, that's an ABO blood grouping system.
Okay.
Then we have the rhesus blood grouping system. We differentiate it into eight, making it A positive, A negative.
So now, wait, sir. So that rhesus now is like the positive and negative,
yes,
of that.
Yes.
Okay, so now that means that me that is O positive now.
You have the rhesus factor.
I have the rhesus factor.
Yes.
Okay.
So anybody that doesn't have it automatically has a rhesus negative.
Okay, now I understand. How is this an issue that would lead a woman having miscarriage? Because that's what I, from my little research, how is this an issue?
Okay. Generally, the rhesus factor has no health challenge to a person, but it only becomes a problem when pregnancy is involved.
Of course, now please, I don't know. Are there couples that would get married and feel they don't want to have a child?
Yes, there are lots of couples that come together and they're like, oh wow, we'll get married, but we will not have kids.
Oh, maybe it's not. I don't know, but I doubt if that one is in African homes. I don't know because.
Your mother.
I can imagine how African mothers will react to this statement you just made now.
But that's the truth, seriously. That's the truth. But then, the rhesus factor being a problem in pregnancy is that most times, the woman being the rhesus negative carrier gets married to a husband or a sperm donor who is rhesus positive. Then there's this high percentage or there's this high chance that the child, or the fetus rather, would carry the positive rhesus factor of the father.
Okay.
Yes. So now, being a rhesus negative mother, her body or her immune system would see that fetus as a foreign substance and would want to attack it.
Oh, I get it. I get it. So now, you said this. Because for me, I understand that if there's an issue, there's always a solution. You understand? So is there a solution for this? Is there a solution for this?
Yes, if it's been identified on time, there's an intramuscular injection, IM, known as Rhesus Immune Globulin G.
You see the problem now. You never even finish the intramuscular, the mosquito. Sorry,
Intramuscular
intramuscular injection.
IM.
It don't begin call. What's the other one you call it again?
Rhesus Immune Globulin G. Okay, the brand name is Rogam.
Do you know it would have been easy for her to just tell me Rogam, and everybody will rest. You see, I think now this whole thing is about pride now, like
Oh,
medical people and their pride, because she had every opportunity to tell me Rogam. Rogam sounds better, guys. Please, do you remember the last one she called? Yeah, I can't remember. Ooh, yeah.
Rhesus Immune Globulin G.
Rhesus
Immune
Immune
Globulin G.
Globulin
Globulin. Calm down, Rogam.
Rogam. Okay, I
Yes.
think I'll stick with Rogam. So now this Rogam now, is it something that people can access easily?
It's not just an OTC. It's not an over-the-counter drug. You don't just get it
You get
anyhow.
ba, you get. Oh, you too, you get ba.
You don't just get
She
it
said
anyhow.
call OTC.
Oh my God.
The way I looked at her, she now said it because it's a feeling I'll soon throw her this pillow because I don't understand the game.
Okay, fine. Sorry. Sorry. Well, it's you are not the one to determine if you're to take it. But being
Okay.
informed and you know that okay, your rhesus negative and you get pregnant, you have to start telling your obstetrician that what are my chances? It could be possible that your body doesn't produce antibodies towards the child during first pregnancy. Because typically, during pregnancy, the mother's blood and that of the fetus doesn't come in contact. But there's minimal contact during delivery.
Okay. Yes, you made mention of whatever that ended with Jim. Me, I've choose Rogam. I've choose Rogam. Is there a way? Is it that people can just buy the drug and then they take it like paracetamol, or is there a way they take the Rogam?
Like I said earlier, it's an injection, intramuscular injection.
Okay.
Yes.
So they insert it the way they give tetanus injection.
It's not insertion, it's
So
injection.
okay, so they inject it the way they give
Yes.
tetanus. Okay,
Yes.
okay, okay.
Now, it's usually given in course of pregnancy, 28 weeks, that's 7 months of pregnancy, and within 72 hours after delivery for future babies.
Oh,
Yes.
okay. I don't know, but do you have any idea about the price of this drug?
Last time I checked, it's about $120.
Ah. So which one is better? I know $120 is about 50,000 naira in
50,000
Nigeria.
naira.
So is it not better you meet the girl on the first day? Because I know, is it genotype before number? Because I know genotype is quite popular. A lot of people talk about genotype a lot, but they don't talk about risk factor. If these days, I see people collect, people ask genotype before number. So instead of paying that 50K, I don't know, is it not better to just ask the person on that first date, what's your risk factor? I don't know, is that not better? And then save the whole stress of having a child and then
Well,
losing it on the long run.
asking is for knowledge sake.
But people ask about genotype comfortably.
Yes, they do.
And then they can equally ask about rhesus factor too.
When you say blood group, when people ask you what's your blood group, what do you tell them?
O positive.
So the positive has taken care of the
Okay,
rhesus
so instead
factor.
of using the word rhesus
You
factor,
don't
just ask,
necessarily need to say what's
okay,
your
just
rhesus
ask
factor.
what's your blood group.
Yes.
On code.
Oncode.
Yeah, I get
What's your
you.
genotype? AA. What's your blood group? O
You will
positive.
just know.
You're good.
Oh. So now we've been saying a lot about the baby being positive, and then the woman, sorry, the baby being negative,
Positive.
positive. Okay, and the woman
Negative.
negative. So what if the other way around? Let's say the woman is positive and the baby is negative. Is there any
There's no
complication?
problem.
Oh, there's no
There's
problem.
no problem at all.
Guys, please, if you're a lady and you are positive, bah.
Yeah, you don't have a problem.
God don't want for you.
Because the universal donor is actually O negative. So even if she being positive comes in contact with the negative child, nothing is wrong. The thing is, the rhesus
Wait,
negative,
you said universal donor is what?
the O negative,
The O negative.
yes, is a universal donor. It gives to everybody.
So
but receive from O negative.
Okay.
So bad, right?
I'm like, please. Anyway, let me just shoot my shot. If you're a lady and you're positive, I beg, send me a DM. She is positive, man. Yeah.
Please don't try to make them feel bad, really. The rapid fact of being negative has no general complications. It doesn't have any health complications.
Hey, but for people that can afford
no,
the drug,
during the pregnancy, just take the dosage and you're good.
So what people that can afford the dosage?
Well, if they can't afford the dosage, then the baby is at risk. Because the baby will have hemolytic disease, HDN, hemolytic disease of the newborn, which could be mild or severe. If it's mild, sometimes there's no treatment. But if it's severe, it can cause jaundice, it can cause liver failure, it can cause heart failure. At the end of the day, the baby might die.
Wow. So, but as they say, prevention is better than cure. So, if you meet someone and you're still getting to know the person, that moment said they say, never allow feelings enter. You know, it's a lot easier to know. It's better to know all these things when you're just meeting the person. Where feelings? Because where feelings come now, that's why I come and say, we can fight for love. Our love conquers all. Love conquers everything. Love can take us places. My brother and sister, it is never a love can carry you. This one, love cannot do it though. So when you've not caused feelings for the person, it's better for you to just know this. Like, just know this.
Yeah.
So for me now, if I should meet a lady and then she's a negative blood, please, the positive we are saying here since is blood though, not HIV positive. It's blood. If you're positive in your blood, you can marry anybody. We don't mean HIV positive, please. I just need to clear that. So for me now, I need to look for someone that is positive, I guess.
Yeah.
Okay.
But if you get someone that is negative that you love, please go ahead and marry the person. But then keep money for Rogam. To avoid trauma, to avoid issues for the child.
Okay, yeah, you said a lot today, and believe me, I know if we should give you more time, you will break down this thing. But we'll likely have to conclude here, and then we'll talk about it more or different topic in our next series. So what do you have to tell us in our conclusion? What do you have to tell us?
Okay, knowing your risk factor is important. If it turns out negative as a lady, taking the adequate dosage as at when due is very much important. Okay. Because most times, first pregnancy, it's fine. But subsequent pregnancies might put the child in the risk of having hemolytic disease of the newborn, known as HDN.
Okay. So you've had a knowing your risk factor is as important as knowing your genotype too. For the sake of your child, please, if you meet any guy, like I said, this one is not about love. It's not everything that love is to conquer. It's not everything, no love. Is everything love is to conquer? It's not everything. Please know your resource factor. We've explained this whole thing well for you to understand. And as you're watching this video, please share it so that people can learn about resource factor. Thank you so much for staying with us. Thank you so much for your time. And also, Sandra, thank you for this wonderful lecture today. Believe me, you've enlightened our audience. You've also enlightened me. I now know much about resource factor. Thank you so much. And we'll see you in the next video. Remember, like, subscribe, and share. Thank you very much.
Bye-bye.